So that was really fun to get in to the vehicle that you know is actually yours, and had the new Soyuz smell too, which made it special. But we're really looking forward to our ride. This is the old Cosmonaut Hotel, which actually most of the training folks actually still stay in here. You can see that the sign on the door says there's still a quarantine here because we come do all our training and classes over here in this building. So we are in quarantine for about 2.5 weeks prior to the launch. Quarantine is actually very important because we don't want to take any illnesses up to the station and infect the rest of the crew up there that's already on board, or to leave those illnesses there. This is the newer hotel facility that we stay in now. It's actually quite nice. So this territory we're on, where the Cosmonaut Hotel is located, is actually probably around 5 acres large, but it ends here with a wall that you can see relatively close in front of us, and then a really pretty little river that goes down along the front end on the east side of the complex.
I've been here a number of times. I've only launched from here once, but when I was deputy chief and chief of the astronaut office, I came down here many times to support other crew members who were launching. And it's a lot more fun to be on the side of the person that's going on the vehicle rather than just to watch. We're going to be doing a 2-day rendezvous, which is actually what I did prior to Expedition 16 as well. I've always said it was probably the 2 most boring days of spaceflight ever. Other than the actual launch phase and the first couple of orbits where we're doing maneuvers, then the phase, the last probably 5 hours before we dock with the station, it's very boring. We just eat and sleep and listen to music. Even looking out the window is actually not all that comfortable because the Soyuz vehicle itself is doing the solar spin to keep all the sides evenly heated. And that ends up, when you look out the window, the Earth will go by this way, and then later on it'll come by in a few seconds, come by from the top and go down. So it's actually kind of disturbing. So not fun to watch from there. So we'll look forward to getting to the station.
Zoom in on your food.
Your Kuzma.
This is the little tree I planted in 2007 before Expedition 16. Each crew member plants a tree on their first flight from the Cosmodrome here in Baikonur. This tree was planted for Alexei Leonov. He was the first man to do a spacewalk. He's actually a really interesting guy, a very good storyteller. This tree was planted for Valentina Tereshkova, the first woman in space, in 1963. Obviously, I don't think this facility was built then, so these trees were planted in their names. And the biggest tree here was planted in Yuri Gagarin's name, and
biggest tree, as it should be, I think. It's O-minus 8, so 8 days before the launch. I don't know if this is going to work out in the dark or not, if there's enough light out here, but I came out for a walk. Today was probably the most beautiful day we've had in Baikonur so far. It was in the low 50s most of the day, so a really pretty day and very clear. But we also have moon tonight, and I came out to look at the moon. I looked to see if there was a space station pass, and there's one tomorrow morning. I'll probably come out and try and look at it. It's always fun to see the station pass overhead, especially I think when you're this close to launch, recognizing that you're going to get to be up in that little speck of light. It's pretty amazing.